Hello students, welcome to my channel Agricultural Engineering Online with continuation of the video lecture series from Farm Machinery. So this video is on chaff cutting. What is chaff cutter? Chaff cutter is a machine used to chop up hay and store to make it into chaff for feeding to cattle. So a chaff cutter is a mechanical machine. If we cut the chaff into small pieces, this will aid to the animal digestion and prevents animals from rejecting any part of their food. Initially, these are the machines we will discuss about in this lecture. Coming to the chopping of green fodder and forage, chopping green fodder and forage for fodder crops are maize crop, sorghum crop and napier grass. These are the three cultivated crops which are used for the green fodder and forage for the cattle or domestic animals. Other natural grasses are grown which can be also fed to the animals. Different ways of chopping: one is hand with a machete, hand operated chopper and engine driven chopper. The benefits of feed chopping is, first of all, it's more palatable to animals if we chop the green fodder for the cattle. Handling is easy and reduces feed wastage, enables ensiling and on-farm mixing, easy to transport and increase storage, capacity of dried and chopper feed increases if we use a mechanical device for the food fodder chopping. Also, it improves the marketability so that it can easily be marketed and farmers can get more money out of this. Coming to the torque required for cutting, first of all, if you see, this is a flywheel of chaff cutter. So here actually the RI is the distance from the flywheel center to the inner edge of the throat in meter. Let's W is the width of throat where actually the chaffs will be cutted into these pieces throughout this throat, and throat is a width height of H, let it in meter. F, let F is the cutting force in Newton required, and R is the effective radius of cutting. Then R will be equal to the distance from the flywheel center, that is RI plus W by 2 width. So basically, the if you see this is the R, that is the effective cutting radius. Therefore, the torque required for the cutting of the chaff will be equal to force required into R, that is the mean radius, you can say effective radius in Newton meter. Then coming to the force required for cutting fodder, there is the W is the width of the throat, H is the height of the throat, area of the throat will be equal to the width into height. And if we see this one, throughout this area crops will be fed. So let it in a number of stems are cut at a time. There means one time number of cuts will be ns. So it depends on the void ratio of the this chaff or number of stems per unit area. So it should be given. Basically, if you see the cuttings, stems will be like this. The number of stems it will be just holding by the throat will be equal to ns. That can be calculated as AT, that is the throat area divided total area divided by number of stems per unit area. If it is given, either the number of stems per unit area would be given, or if you know the void ratio, then you can also calculate the number of stems cut at a time. Let us see, sigma is the shear stress of material in Newton per meter square. There is Newton per meter square. And F is the force required for cutting, that is N Newton. Therefore, the force will be equal to area into number of A is the cross section area of each stem, stem area, cross sectional area, and number of stem into the each stem area will be equal to total area into, that is the sigma is the shear stress to cut the material. Therefore, the force required for the cutting will be equal to sigma A into ns. And if the void ratio is given, the void ratio is like this, total area minus stem area divided by total area. So if void fraction is given, then total area is given, then you can calculate the stem area. So once you find out the stem area, instead of ANS, so you can directly put the stem area into this, so you can find out the total force required for the cutting of the fodder. Therefore, ANS is equal to 80 into 1 minus F, F is the void fraction. If it is given, then directly you can calculate. Coming to the power requirement, so once you know the force or torque required, torque is equal to already force into R. So therefore, T is F into R, and N is the speed of the flywheel, then T is the cutting torque already calculated, then power will be equal to 2 pi into by 16 to 10 to the 3 kilowatt. Coming to the length of cut of feed by feed roller, this is very important to calculate. So if you know this is the flywheel and it's having a number of blades over it, and RI is the that is the radius of throat, inner radius, inner throat of the distance from the center to the inner throat, that is RI, and let it, there is the number of knives of the flywheel of cutter or cutter head. So in this case 3 is showing, and let its diameter of the flywheel is D or DF flywheel, F for flywheel, and it's rotating at a speed of NF, or you can say RPM of the flywheel is this one. So if you know this, when you attach it with a power source, then it will rotate at a speed of NF. Therefore, the knife spacing on flywheel will be equal to the perimeter, there is pi DF divided by N is the number of knives. That is LK, that is the knife spacing on the flywheel. Mostly it is not required from this point to this point. So this is the you can say length of the knife spacing, you can see. Coming to the peripheral velocity of the flywheel, so it's very simple, that is pi dn by 60, so pi df nf by 60 in meter per second. Coming to the feeder, feeding is done generally by a feed roller. So let it, the diameter of the feed roller is, let it, it's, now we are taking as a belt and a roller, so belt feeding system. In the belt feeding system, that is the roller is having a diameter of dr, is the roller diameter. Then the RPM of the roller is nr, it's a rotating so that it can feed the crop to the flywheel. The belt velocity will be same as the linear velocity of the roller. Therefore, the peripheral velocity of feed roller or linear velocity of feed roller will be equal to vr, that is pi dr nr by 60 meter per second. It's very simple. The two things are there, one is the velocity of the flywheel, or in turn the velocity of the knife divided, and also the peripheral velocity of the feed roller. So there is a relation, from there you can calculate the length of cut. Therefore, to find out the length of cut, already you discussed, the feed roller might be the belt type or direct, you can say another type also it will be there. Let it, L is the length of cut for the chaff, we have to find out. So L will be equal to this much. So between one cutting and another cutting, so if you see, this is the crop is fed here, the fodder, and it is come out. So therefore the length will be this much. So the length of cut will be the how much it moves, linear movement of the crop or fodder between two cuts, consecutive cuts. Therefore, the another type of feeding is the two rollers having some gap in between. So both will rotating at a opposite clockwise or anticlockwise, and dr is the same as the roller diameter. So in from this actually you can calculate the length of cut of chaff or feed will be equal to pi dr nr by L, nf into n. So how do you get? You see, this L is equal to lk into vr by vf. So vr and vf is the velocity ratio between the roller divided by flywheel. This is very important. So velocity ratio between the there is the peripheral velocity between the flywheel divided by velocity ratio of feed roller into that is knife spacing. Knife spacing already you calculate the LK. LK is pi df by n. There is the peripheral length divided by number of knives into that is VR is pi dr nr by 60 and VF is pi df na by 60. So we cancel out each other. Therefore, the final expression for the length of cut of chap or feed will be equal to pi dr nr by nf into n, where dr is the diameter of the feed ruler, nr is the speed of the feed ruler, nf is the number speed of the flywheel, n is the number of knives in the flywheel. Therefore, we can also say that the length of cut generally varies or directly proportional to the dia of feed ruler or speed of the feed ruler. Also, it is indirectly proportional to or inversely proportional to number of knives on the flywheel and also speed of the flywheel. If the clearance angle between knife and plane of motion is known, that is alpha, so the angle generally the flywheel moves on a plane, rotates on a plane, and if you see the knives are attached with a laser plate and that is having certain angle, so that angle of rotation and knife angle, whatever the clearance angle is given, then we can calculate the length of cut in meter will be equal to 2 pi r into 10 alpha divided by n. So instead of this ri, this will be r, where r is the mean radius. So mean radius, that is the distance between the center of the flywheel to the center of the throat. Here n is the number of knives. Here actually no need to calculate the speed of the flywheel or speed of the feed ruler. Coming to the capacity of the chap cutter, which can be calculated by knowing the width of throat and height of the throat, whereas the A is the cross section area of the throat, that is in meter square, will be equal to W into H. If we know the bulk density of the feed material, that is kg per cubic meter, then the capacity of the chap cutter in ton per hour will be equal to 16 to 10 to the minus 3 into rho into ALNF into n in ton per hour, where actually rho is the bulk density in kg per cubic meter, 60 is multiplied for the hour, A is the area of the throat in meter square, L is the length of cut in meter, nf is the speed of the flywheel in RPM, because the RPM will be per minute, so multiply by 60 it will be hour, and n is the number of knives on the flywheel. So therefore, instead of ALNF, we can write down the as Q, where Q can be called as the flow rate of the feed material in cubic meter per minute in this case. So multiplied by this is volume per minute, and multiplied by 60, that is volume per hour, and 10 to the minus 3 is for the ton, because 1000 kg is 1 ton, and Q can be also called as W into H is the area, L NF into N. Therefore, this way you can calculate the capacity of the chap cutter in ton per hour. I hope you understand everything about the chap cutter. Please like and subscribe to my channel.